الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله، صلى الله وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي البهي وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the master of the whole universe, and I bear witness that there is no God but Allah. I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final and the sealed messenger of Allah. We are sending our blessings and our salutations to all the prophets and the messengers of Allah, starting from Adam all the way down to Noah, to Moses, Jesus, and also to the prophet Ibrahim, and also till we come to the prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless our gathering. Allahumma ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those people who are listening to the commands of Allah and the commands of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they submit accordingly and they surrender for the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah accept your fasting at the first day of Dhul Hijjah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst the righteous people and guide all our steps to Jannatul Firdaus. Allahumma ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. Welcome back, alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored us by giving us another opportunity so we can come together, we can meet for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And first off, let me welcome my shaykhs, my two imams, Imam Jalal and Imam Muhammad Yahya. And alhamdulillah, you are familiar with the names and with our imams, mashallah, our great scholars. They are very known and famous, alhamdulillah, in our area in Florida and beyond these areas, alhamdulillah. Let me welcome them first. Assalamu alaikum, Imam Jalal Abdul Wahid.
Alaikum assalam, rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Sayyidina Mawlana, ahlan wa sahlan.
Ya marhaba, Mawlana, ya marhaba. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Muhammad.
Alaikum assalam, rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
It's something, you know, it's a privilege and advantage when we come at the first days of the Hijjah, making dua and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And just before, inshallah, I give the microphone to my Sheikh Imam Jalal. One of the points that I was discussing today with one of my friends in Egypt, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us seasons for worship. That's the seasons for worship, that may be different. So we were in Ramadan and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us the last 10 nights of Ramadan, then the night of Laylatul Qadr. Then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us another season, another opportunity, so we can enhance and strengthen our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is by the grace of Allah, by His mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give us another time for the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the blessed 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. My Sheikh Imam Jalal, can you please share with us some of your thoughts about Dhul Hijjah? What does it mean for you? What does it mean to witness the first days of Dhul Hijjah?
Jazakallah. Yes, sir. Jazakumullah khairan. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen. سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. حياكم الله وجزاكم الله خير الدنيا والآخرة. سيدنا مولانا الشيخ أحمد علي بارك الله فيكم، وسيدنا مولانا الشيخ محمد يحيى جزاكم الله خيرا، والحضور الكرام. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى جل شأنه وعظمت قدرته، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وربك يخلق ما يشاء ويختار، سبحان الله العظيم، من سورة القصص. الله سبحانه وتعالى. My dear respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. All praise due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We thank Allah for this beautiful gathering. الحمد لله رب العالمين. For the first day and night in the month of the حد الحجة. I thank my brother Sheikh Ahmed Ali and my other brother Sheikh Muhammad Yahya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and reward them at this dunya and hereafter. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And I thank as well everybody attend to this beautiful gathering and all Muslim Ummah. Ameen, Ya Rabbi Al-Alameen. Allah Azza wa Jal said in Surah Al-Qasas, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. Indeed, your Lord, He created whatever He wants and He will and He chooses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Azza wa Jal, He the one who created everything. He created the heavens and He chose the seven heavens to be the best among them. He created the angels and He chose Jibra'il alayhi salam to be the best of the angels. He created the time and He chose the night of the power, Laylatul Qadr, to be the best night. And also he created the sign and He chose the day of Arafah to be the best day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human beings. He created the al-khalq, al-bashar. And He chose the messengers and the prophets to be among them, to be the best among them. And also He chose among the messengers, Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, peace and blessing be to him alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to be the best. So Allah chose those 10 days. All good actions is good every day. And Allah accepted. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love it. But especially on these days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prefer them. This is the favorites of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These 10 days. And that's why they are so important, my brother. And the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, all good deeds. All great deeds, we can do it, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. That's why they are so special.
Barakallahu feek, Shaykhana, Jazakallahu khairan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. And when it comes to the first 10 days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swore in the Quran by the first 10 days of the Hijjah when Allah said, wal fajri wa layalin ashr. And yesterday I was talking with our brothers and sisters in the masjid. And I quizzed them with the question, and let me, before listening to Imam Yahya, inshallah, just let me tell you the question and you can type your answer if you wanted. It's related to the takbir. When the takbir should start? When the takbir should start? And also, what are the types of the takbir? That's a very important question. So, please type your answer if you can. And inshallah, let me go back to Imam Muhammad. We need to know more about the Hijjah, about the virtues of the Hijjah, inshallah. Jazakallahu khair.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Could I answer this question and then I share a prize with the brothers? Inshallah, it's a very simple question. I assume that everybody, inshallah, is adjusted with this question, these answers, alhamdulillah. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His help and forgiveness. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day, every night, every time and everywhere. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave us the ability to come and to meet at this point in time. If it were not for Allah, then we would not be able to gather right now. If it were not for Allah, then we would not be able to move and to to do anything, because everything is going by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If it were not for Allah, then our bodies will cease to function. So we say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. The first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. First, I will take the point from Imam Ahmad when he started by saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made seasons for ta'ah and for, let's say, striving oneself and exerting much effort to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ لِرَبِّكُمْ فِي أَيَّامِ دَهْرِكُمْ لَنَفَحَاتٍ. And then Shaykh Jalal mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preferred and chose some days and some nights and some places to be the best, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything and He has the power over the whole universe. I want just in these 2 minutes to emphasize the quality of these days. because we have something we call it sharaf al-zaman and sharaf al-makan. Sharaf al-zaman, all of us know that at the last 10 nights of Ramadan, we all seek and look for Laylat al-Qadr during the night time. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Inna anzalnahu fi Laylat al-Qadr." So the virtue, the quality of these days or of this time is at night. But during these first 10 days of the Hijjah, we should try our best during the daytime also, because these are the best 10 days. So a sharaf, the honor, the power, the mercy and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down during the daytime of the first 10 of the Hijjah. Of course, all times and all places, but still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose whatever He wants and made it very special to come closer to Him and to exert much effort during the daytime. That's why all of us, you know, this is very, very famous that all people around the world tries to make siyam during the daytime so that they could hit the target. They could collect, you know, a lot of rewards to be added to their record, inshallah, when they get back to Allah. So I just wanted to emphasize that don't ever miss the blessings of the daytime, because all of us know that the nighttime is the best during, you know, the whole year, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يتنزل الله تعالى إلى السماء الدنيا نزولا يليق بعظمته وجلاله وكماله في كل ليلة وينادي ويقول هل من تائب فأتوب عليه هل من مستغفر فأغفر له هل من تائب فأتوب عليه. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls upon us every single night for those who want to make repentance, for those who seek the mercy of Allah, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that He will give them whatever they ask for. But still, don't ever miss the blessings of the daytime. Now I want to listen to Imam Ahmad also to add some of the virtues of these 10 days and how could we invest this time. Usually I say to my brothers and sisters in the masjid, if you make a plan for something, you will invest it very well. Thank you.
Jazakumullah khairan, Shaykhana, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all with Allahumma ameen. And yes, these are the most special days of the year. Why that? Why the first 10 days of the Hijjah are so special? Let's count. You are fasting in these 10 days of the Hijjah. Number two, you are giving the charity in the form of the sacrifice. When you slaughter your udhiyah, you give to the poor and needy. And number two, you will have a group of hujjaj, of those people who are performing the pilgrimage, the hajj, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are standing on the mountain of the Arafat. They are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the forgiveness. So you have salah, you have siyam, you have charity, you have that, you know, appealing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Him for the forgiveness. That is why it is the best days ever. And it has the great rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels will descend, will come down to the earth, and they will be witnessed by the day of Arafah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proudly will say to the angels, look at my servants. They came for me, they sacrificed, they did a lot, and they did that for my sake. Be witness that I forgive all their sins. That's why it is so amazing. It is astonishing when it comes to the forgiveness of the first days of the Hijjah. You need, as a Muslim, even if you will not go to Hajj, you need to invest these days. You need to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to do your effort. You need to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when it comes to the worship, when it comes to the siyam, as we yesterday we discussed, siyam in the first 10 days of the Hijjah has its benefits, has its, you know, unique form because it was the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So before we are talking about also the virtues, we can have this hadith, and I want Imam Jalal, inshallah, to share with us this hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ فِيهَا أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنْ تِلْكَ الْعَشْرِ. That means, look at this profound statement. The most best days ever that you can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And you may wonder, what about the days of Dhul Hijjah, the first 10 days and the last 10 nights of Ramadan? Who are the best? These 10 days or these 10 days? Yes, Imam Jalal.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah Azza wa Jal said and joined in a lot of ayat in the Quran al-Azim. He said, "Inna alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat." Indeed, those who believe, then they do the righteous way, the righteous action, the righteous work. So the belief is so important. Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He the creator. He the one who created everything. Believe that the land belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We are belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to Him we're gonna return. Soon or later, we're gonna return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we think about it, my dear respected brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we are life now. A lot of people. We know a lot of people, they are with the COVID-19, subhanallah al-azim, they passed away. But we're still living, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. So we can do more and more and more action, more good deed at these beautiful days. So the righteous work depends on they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe that the money for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا جَعَلَكُمْ مُسْتَخْلَفِينَ فِيهِ. Indeed, you spend from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you and sustain you and provide you. So everything belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The whole matters belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why these days, so important. It's looked like so important to do more actions. And like my brother, Sheikh Ahmed, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him, said, why this 10 days is so important? Because it has all ibadah, all kind of worshiper, subhanallah al-azim, all kind there. You will bear witness that Allah is one, and with no associate, with no partners. You make this, you perform salah, you make the hajj, subhanallah al-azim, and if you did not make the hajj, here we sacrifice also in the sake of Allah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we fasting. So all those, alhamdulillah, and we pay surety and we pay sadaqah, we feel the other people, we are gathered together in the house of Allah, all these good actions. And in the night time, like my other brother, Sheikh Muhammad, he said, like when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Prophet Muhammad and gave him an order, Ya ayyuhal muzzammil, qum al-layla illa qaleela. This is the beautiful night between you and your Lord, between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At this time, just nobody seeing you but Allah azza wa jal. So you say whatever you want and you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is a lot of mercy, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wallahi, Allah, like we said last time, Allahu latifun bi'ibadi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gentle with His servants. And that's why Allah give us opportunity and after opportunity to do good deed and to do more for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why the reward, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it more and more, double and triple. And no limit, no limitation, because this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created everything. So when we do good action at these days, and there's a lot of good action, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, a lot, it's unlimited good action between dhikr and inshallah, I just didn't want to take my, you know, a lot of time, inshallah, we're going to say what the anwa' al-ibadat fi at this 10 days, inshallah rabbil alameen. جزاكم الله خيرا شيخنا.
جزاكم الله خيرا شيخنا، بارك الله فيكم، يا الله سبحانه وتعالى bless you. But before we listen to Imam Yahya, we have mashallah on Zoom now almost like 48 persons, and we just got like 5-6 answers. Let me repeat the question: when the takbir should start? So people are feeling lazy to type, okay? Mashallah, we have good number also on Facebook. So we need you to interact and let us know when the takbir should start. We will listen to Imam Yahya and we will get back to you to answer this question, inshallah. Yes, Imam.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome back. You know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like we said, alhamdulillah, He gave us like the opportunity again to get back to Him. You know, just check your status. What happened after Ramadan? Alhamdulillah, during the month of Ramadan, we're like competing amongst one another. Those people are trying to read the whole Quran during the month of Ramadan. And those people are trying to stand in Qiyam al-Layl, like Salat al-Taraweeh or Salat al-Tahajjud. However the term you want to use for this, they are both are correct. So, but after Ramadan, to be honest, most of the people, including myself, most of the people started to feel a little lazy and decided to get indulged into the business and all these things that take us away from the, like, focusing in our worshiping to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why this is, let's take these 10 days like an alert from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get back to Allah. Still the question is, how could we invest these days? Let me tell you that all people, I'm pretty sure that all people, if you wanna take like a step in a new business or something, I'm pretty sure that everybody should plan for this business, should sit and write down what could I do and what are the profits and I mean the benefit, what are the points, what are the obstacles I might face in this business. So they try to plan for the business. The fact is, the best project in this life is to get the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this is the only thing that you will find when you get back in our journey back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Yawm al-Qiyamah. This is the only project that will benefit you. Yes, still you have to, you need, it's okay for you to get the benefit of this life, to lead a happy life, to collect a lot of money, to be happy in your life, you and your family and all people around you in your communities. But still, as you know that the Prophet ﷺ says, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمْ إِنْ قَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ صَدَقَةٌ جَارِيَةٌ أَوْ عِلْمٌ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ أَوْ وَلَدٌ صَالِحٌ يَدْعُ لَهُ. So the real project and the real happiness is to think about the hereafter, is to plan for yourself. Now I got the opportunity, alhamdulillah, and we are alive, as Imam Jalal said, alhamdulillah, and we are in a good health. May Allah protect all of us and all people around the world. So if we just take it like step by step and we feel lazy and we postpone and we delay ta'ah, we're not going to get the benefit of these days. What I want to say to all brothers and sisters, please, tonight, before you go to bed, just put a plan for these. They are not 10. They are not 9. They're just 8 before the day of Eid, because the first day is already done. And the day of Eid, we can't make Siyam during the day of Eid, which is the 10th day of the Hijjah. So you just have like 8 days you could make Siyam. If you can't make Siyam during the whole days, like the 8 days, just think about making Siyam in your weekends, in your days off from work. Put a plan for your dhikr, to say Astaghfirullah 100 times, to follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and to do takbir, and to do La ilaha illallah, subhanallah, and all kinds of, you know, this is very, very easy and simple worship, dhikrullahi azza wa jal. So the point is, please try to put a plan for yourself tonight, not tomorrow. It should be tonight, because time is too fast, and there are like very few days. If we don't plan for it, we will definitely miss it. May Allah give us the benefit of these days. Ameen.
Jazakumullah khairan, Shaykhana. Barakallah subhanahu wa ta'ala feekum. And still, I didn't get more answers. So people feel, I think they maybe got their breakfast and they, mashallah, they now they are full they need to sleep. Let's move ahead before Adhan al-Isha, inshallah. And before that, let's remind everyone that for the takbir, we have two types of takbir. Let me share with you some of the answers, mashallah. I got from Brother Izzuddin, I got from many of the brothers, Brother, yes, the, mashallah, Mrs. Gil Siddiqui, mashallah, barakallahu feekum, mashallah, we are so happy to have you. Brother Izzuddin, mashallah, also, and Brother Rizwan, Allahu Akbar, mashallah, Hajj Rizwan from New York. So let's have the answer. We have two types of takbir, two types. Number one is called the general one, the general takbir. It starts at the night, the beginning of Dhul-Hijjah. We know the beginning of the day starts from the night. The first night of Dhul-Hijjah, and it continues till 13th of Dhul-Hijjah. 13th of Dhul-Hijjah. So this is the time that we can have as a time for takbir. That's the general time for takbir. Then we have the restricted one. We call it mutlaq and muqayyad. The general one and the restricted one. Restricted one means that's the takbir which starts at the fajr of the day of Eid, after Salat al-Fajr of the day of Eid. And that continues till...
You mean the day of Arafah,
the
right?
Day, sorry, the day of Arafah. And that continue till the fourth day of Eid, till Asr. So that is after each Salah, after each Fard Salah. So this is the time that you have the restricted takbir. But the general takbir, you can do takbir right now in your house. So that's the sunnah that I wanted you to apply. Now you are sitting in your house, you have your wife, you have your children, your grandchildren. Let's make takbir for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying, all of us, let's practice this for three times, inshallah. Let's make us all say this takbir. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La
ilaha illallah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. That's the first time. We still have two times. I see kids, mashallah, they are next to Brother Rizwan. My kids are here. So let's encourage them to have takbir. Allahu Akbar,
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Wa lillahi
alhamd.
That's two. Number three. Allahu
Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar.
You can do that always, not only in the masjid, in your house, in the marketplace, whatever you are, in your parking lot. You know, it's general takbir. It's you are free to do any time at night when you wake up, when after lunch, whatever you are. And also when it comes to the restricted ones, that can be after your salah, even the fard salah, even if you are in your house. Let's revive the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by spreading takbir everywhere. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us, Allahumma ameen. My Imam Shaykh Galal, what's the advice? The practical steps that you can share with us to the brothers and sisters in these blessed days, inshallah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, my brother Ahmed. MashaAllah, jazakumullah khairan. The best thing, you remember in the night of the power, in Laylatul Qadr, what we said, what did the dua Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam taught us? اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. How about these days if we forgive the other people for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Whatever they did to us, what kind of harming they did to us. And we have uswatun hasana, we have the best example with the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. When the people of the Mecca, their cousins and their family, his family and his cousins and his people, the people who grew up with them, then after that they said, they think to kill him. And they, you know, they, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the order to go to Medina. You know, after that, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened to him Mecca again, and he back to Mecca, he put his head down. Allahu Akbar. See how the Prophet, how the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, he put his head down. So simple and so humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't back to revenge. No. He didn't say that, or he didn't mean that. And he ate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he the one who gave him the victory. But he forgave them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same thing as well. This is the methods of the believer and the methods of the messengers, al-anbiya. How about dhikrullah, my dear respected brothers and sisters? Dhikrullah, when you remember Allah, when you say Allah, when you remember the name of Allah, then Allah remember you by your name. Imagine my brother, Sheikh Ahmed and Sheikh Muhammad Yahya and all Muslims, Ummah subhanallah. Imagine when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remember you and call you by name, Ahmed Ali, Ahmed Asam, remember, wallahi, what's more honor than that? What more dignity than that? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created us, he just remember us by our names. Isn't Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who said, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ, remember me, I remember you. Subhanallah al-Azim. Is this a lot, my dear respected brothers and sisters? It's a lot to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to forgive the people, forgiveness for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in order Allah to forgive us, you know, in order for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us in a day of judgment. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. To give more charity, to give more sadaqah for the sake of Allah. Jazakumullah khairan Sayyidina. Sheikh Muhammad, inshallah, gonna share us.
Jazakumullah khairan. Shaykhana, before we move to Imam Yahya, inshallah, because we get close to Adhan al-Isha, just wanted to let you know, inshallah, that the next lecture will be Sunday, inshallah, almost at the same time, because we need to give people time so they can break their fast. And before we listen to Imam Yahya, if you want, inshallah, to let us include any of your relatives or beloved ones in our dua before Isha, just write down the names. I got Sister Shiron, and inshallah, and also Mom Afsari. And also, I want you to write down the names on the chat so we can include them in the dua, inshallah. Yes, Imam Muhammad.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I'm going to end up with this, inshallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, I'm just want to emphasize the point. Let me ask you first. Why does we say that dhikrullah or praying during the night is the best? All of us could say because the other people are sleeping, right? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, ibadatun fil harji or fil harji kahijratin ilayya. So the worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the time of tribulations is as great as migrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the point is, when all people are busy in business, in life, in collecting money, in doing this and doing that, in just getting busy about their family, everything, you devote your life for the sake of Allah. You try to exert your effort to remember Allah during the daytime. This is the main point, that when you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the time of trials, at the time of tribulations, at this time when the people are running around frantically, all people are getting into trials and tribulations, and you just try to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the exact same as you try to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the time and all people are sleeping, Now we are trying to worship Allah during the daytime while other people are just busy about their, you know, worldly life. I hope that each and everybody try to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to invest the time during these 10 days, because they are the best 10 days ever, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells, and they are the most beloved days to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in return, Allah wants to hear from you. Allah wants to listen to your dua, because He promised, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ دَعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. So remember Allah, make dua to Allah, try to make siyam specifically in the day of Arafat. Don't ever miss making siyam in the day of Arafat. You will get your all your sins, past sins, forgiven, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to worship Him in the excellent manner. وَأَخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.
Jazakumullah khairan, Shaykhana. My message to everyone is watching me right now. Here are the times of worship. This is the time for competition. This is the time that you can show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala your best. These are the times that you can say to Allah, oh Allah, you granted us the season for worship, the season for forgiveness, the season for mercy. We are your servants and we are here to grab the chance and to invest every single minute in these 10 days, inshallah, of Dhul-Hijjah. Before we make the dua, inshallah, Imam Jalal, Jazakumullah khairan for sharing time with us.
Jazakumullah khairan, barakallahu feekum.
We are so honored, so blessed to have you, Imam Jalal, inshallah, wallahi.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. I have the honor, wallahi, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, and gonna be all the same. Jazakumullah khairan.
Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen. Imam Yahya, we are so blessed to have you. Inshallah, we need to see you more and more, inshallah. Remember, Sunday, inshallah, at 9, inshallah, for the brothers and sisters. Let's make the dua. And we are making dua for our sister, Shiron, who passed away this afternoon. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower her with His mercy. Amen. We make dua for Karshid Ahmed, who passed away today in India. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower him with His mercy. We make dua for Hajj Abdul Rafiq. And we make dua also for Brother Rizwan's family, his mother, Hajunid Janit Rafiq, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give her shifa. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. We make dua for Sister Nadia Mijibur and Tawus bin Salim and Brother Muhammad, the parents of Brother Fazl, Muhammad Hadi, and Aqlima, and brother-in-law who passed away, Muhammad Sajid. We make dua also for Ismail Mijpur and Brother Zaf, his sister Zalina. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless everyone. Allahumma ameen. And also for Dr. Javid, make dua. Yes, mashallah, ya Rabb, inshallah, to be Imam and Imam Tariq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless everyone, Allahumma ameen. The one who, Allahumma ameen, barakallahu feek. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless everyone, Allahumma ameen, ya Rabb al-alameen. We have also Auntie Shaheed and Rosa and Fatima. May Allah give them shifa, Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen, because they are so sick. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds, Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And also, we make dua for Mom Afsari, and she, alhamdulillah, she started to feel well little by little, but we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to complete her shifa and to give her more iman so it can be resilient more and more, and know that everything comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma ameen. And we are giving her the message, be strong and be, you know, have the iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah will give you more and more reward, inshallah. You are the best amongst us, inshallah, because Allah tested you well and you responded positively to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah continue your shifa. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Let's make dua for everyone, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins. Allahumma ameen يا رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خيرا. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى accept our deeds. اللهم آمين.
آمين.
اللهم لك الحمد يا ربنا كما تحب وكما ترضى. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم اشف كل مريض. اللهم عاف كل مبتلى. اللهم توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين واحشرنا يا ربنا في زمرة خير المرسلين. اللهم اجبر كسرنا. اللهم اجبر ضعفنا. اللهم ارفع الغمة عن العالم بأسره يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشف كل مريض يتألم. اللهم كن للضعفاء وكن للمساكين. اللهم تقبل صيامنا. اللهم ارزقنا وقوفا بعرفات. وارزقنا اللهم سعيا بين الصفا والمروة. اللهم توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين واحشرنا يا ربنا في زمرة خير المرسلين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خيرا.
جزاكم الله خيرا.
We also make dua for the deceased parents, Muhammad and Shafrin Sharif. We will give back to Imam Muhammad Yahya to listen to his adhan from Masjid Danida, inshallah. We are thanking also our brothers and sisters who were joining us on Facebook. Brother Maher Badawi, mashallah, answered the question on Facebook. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless everyone. Allahumma ameen. Imam Amen. Muhammad Yahya, you still with us?
Yes.
Yes, please. Adhan, inshallah, for Isha. Jazakumullah khair.
Thank you.
جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم يا الله سبحانه وتعالى اللهم امين. Thank you everyone joining you for the brothers and sisters from Islamic Center of Burichi Rahman Tarpon Spring from Masjid Salam Dunedin and also from New York Masjid Rahman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless everyone. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Jazakumullah khairan Imam Jalal barakallahu feek.
جزاكم الله خيرا بارك الله فيكم سيدنا
أسعدتنا وشرفتنا بارك الله فيكم
بارك الله فيكم جزاكم الله خيرا
شيخ محمد يحيى
آمين يا رب وإياكم thank you
بارك الله فيكم شيخنا إن شاء الله see you Sunday إن شاء الله at the same time. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.